everybody. Welcome to Good Turn Daily. Today we're going to be turning a alder bowl. You can tell by the blank that I got has a lot of color in it. And I got really excited when the gentleman that gave me the wood, I don't usually turn anything that has a lot of color to it. And I know that alder is more of a softer wood, and so I was pretty excited, but I'll tell you, alder is really dusty too. But I hope you guys enjoy my channel. I really appreciate you being here, and please hit like if you like my videos. I usually put a little comments area, or you know, just something asking questions. But let me know what you think. But you can see that I've got this on 8-speed, but this thing just turns like a dream. I had absolutely no catches at all. Usually, for my bowls, I like to have the recess in there. I've had a lot of them, as you can tell from my other videos. A lot of them, well, I've had two break out on me. And so, the key to it is you have to make your mortise deep. And if you do that, then they usually won't break out on you. Now the bad thing to that is you can't go extremely deep with the bowl. And I don't know if you saw that or not, but the grain color on the bottom of that bowl is just amazing. And look how well it shines up, and that's just sandpaper. Started out using a skew, and then I thought, okay, we're gonna go to a gouge that I have. I'm not real impressed with it, but it was doing a pretty good job because this alder is so dry. And then I decide to go and give it a little sharpen, and then I also kind of change the heel on it a little bit too. I give it a little bit more of a heel. And once I did that, this thing started working like a dream. I'd really like to get some other gouges, like a fingernail gouge and maybe a 40-40 grind. Sorry about the wood piece there. I do eventually blow them off, and a lot of times the wood just knocks them off, so. I was really hoping not to tear through the bottom of that, but I think all in all I got about a quarter inch thick down at the bottom and also in the walls. Flat edge of that skew, it just makes everything so nice and even. And look at the color on there, it's so pretty. Very thankful that he gave that to me, but in return he gets this bowl, so it's all right. He feeds my passion, and I give him a gift. see with the sandpaper, I started out with the 80 grit, and then I moved to 220, and then from 220 I go to 500, and this time I stopped at 500, but a lot of times I'll go to 1,000. So with this, I'm putting my own abrasive paste that I made out of beeswax and mineral oil, and it actually worked really well. I'm surprised at how well it works. But it definitely works to rub it on first and then turn the lathe on, and then now here is just some feed and wax. That feed and wax is amazing stuff. I never really thought that it was going to be that good, but wow, it does a great job. Now here, what I'm doing is I'm putting shellac on top of the wax, and I give it a couple coats and just put it on wet and then let it dry itself. I'm going to slow this down a little bit, and hopefully the volume is a little bit better. I'm sorry for the other volume. You might have to turn up your computer or whatever. But look at the chatoyance on here. A lot of people don't like turning alder and the looks of alder, but this came out really colorful. But I'd like to thank you for joining me today. If you're a subscriber, thanks so much for subscribing. If you like the video, please hit like, but mostly I really appreciate the comments, and so go ahead and leave a comment down below. But I hope you have a great Easter, and just remember to do a good turn daily. Thanks for joining me, guys.